Hi guys, Drummersilas here, bringing you this game review of The Mask for the Super Nintendo. While this game didn't do anything new in terms of gameplay, I did enjoy playing it, as it really captured the sense of the film and the animated cartoon series. This game really made you feel like you were the mask and were in possession of all of these outlandish superpowers, which is what a game based on a comic should do in my opinion. Well, I hope you enjoyed this game review of The Mask for the Super Nintendo.
The Mask is a 2D side-scrolling action game developed by Black Pearl Software and published by Virgin Interactive, released for the Super Nintendo in 1995. The player controls Stanley Ipkiss, a mild-mannered bank clerk who lives in Edge City and transforms into the eponymous Mask upon discovery of the Green Loki Mask. The player has to negotiate through Stanley's apartment, a high-rent district, a bank, a park, a local prison, and finally through a nightclub to confront the final boss in the game, Dorian, who is also wearing the mask. If the player runs out of health, then they return to being Ipkiss, clad in his pajamas, and he is more susceptible to enemy attacks since he does not have the powers of the mask. Only health power-ups can return him to being the eponymous character. Many of the mask's moves in the game are based on those from the movie, such as the mallet, the tornado attack, his assortment of guns that he pulls from his pocket, and the huge living horn. The game also features other moves like the sneaking move, which makes the mask invisible, the dash, including the super dash, where the mask runs at supersonic speed, and the primary punching attack, with cartoon boxing gloves. The majority of these moves uses the mask's morph power, which is replenished with power-ups, although if the morph gauge depletes entirely, it does slowly regenerate on its own. My favourite move in the game, aside from the tornado attack, is the mask's ability to zip through pipes, warping you to different parts of a level. This comes in particularly handy when trying to get through seemingly blocked off areas, and I thought the animation effect when warping through pipes looked suitably effective. Although the game is based on the film, I feel its tone is more similar to the 90s animated series, and its more farcical nature. The graphics, while not the best on the SNES, are well animated, particularly the mask himself in his bright yellow suit, and when he performs moves such as the tornado. Everything else in the game looks quite dark and gritty. In fact, I'd go as far to say that the mask is the only colourful sprite in the game, and its dark colour palette reminds me of Batman Returns. It more or less uses the same pastel colours. The music, composed by Phil Cretzano, is functional at best, but does not feature any standout compositions, aside from when it tries to emulate the music from the film, although there are satisfying sound effects. There were some other effects I liked, such as the bouncing alarm clock and Stanley's dog, Milo, wearing the mask. These little touches really brought out the spirit of the film, capturing its zaniness and off-the-wall humour. Like many side-scrollers, The Mask doesn't bring anything new to the table, and instead employs the formulaic point A to point B style of gameplay. The platforming elements can be broken at times, since there are many floating platforms you have to jump across, and coupled with the fact that the jumping mechanic is hit and miss, you often find yourself missing platforms altogether and falling to your death. Furthermore, the game is very unforgiving in terms of difficulty, with most enemies being able to land a number of hits on you before you can retaliate, which by that point is often too late. The special moves are the best way to deal with the enemies, however, their usage drains the morph gauge, so you cannot rely on these moves throughout the game, forcing you to use your basic punch attacks, which are quite weak. I thought the level design was well done though, creating some quite complex obstacles to negotiate, ensuring that players have to use their heads in order to think of inventive solutions to get through the levels, which I appreciated. Checkpoints are few and far between, meaning that when you die, you may have to start large chunks of the level all over again, which seriously hinders your progression and is incredibly annoying. I would have to restart large portions of levels throughout the game before I even came close to the end. It was that difficult. There is little in the way of replay value, and simply completing the game just feels like an achievement. However, for all the shortcomings The Mask has, it is a fun, faithful adaptation of the film, and really captures the imagination, quirkiness, and outlandish humour that The Mask is all about. There may not be much incentive to play the game again, but I would recommend this game to any fan of the film, comics, and cartoon series, and anyone who just enjoys platforming games. All in all, The Mask for the Super Nintendo is a by-the-numbers side-scrolling game that does its best to invoke the atmosphere of the source material.
Well, that was my review of The Mask for the Super Nintendo. If you like this video, please leave a comment in the section below, as I like to hear your opinions on this game. Rate this video, and if you're new to my work, please support me by subscribing to my channel. Well, until next time, peace out, guys.